What do you have to say to the people?
The people.
I love you guys.
The much-anticipated Season 4 of Cobra Kai is definitely a binger. We're taking a peek behind the scenes at what went into creating such an epic season, and how they plan on navigating elements of the weakest movie in the trilogy, Karate Kid 3. Let's check it out. Number 1. Despite what your mom says about it rotting your brain, you can learn a thing or two from TV. There's no lack of training in Cobra Kai. When asked if the kids could hold their own outside of the show, Mary Mouser had this to say.
I feel like I could cause some pain if I had to.
Peyton List, on the other hand, admits that karate is more about stopping attacks than giving them.
I don't know how the power would be behind it, but the moves would look great.
And actually, a big chunk of every day is spent in training. Peyton says she works with her stunt double, Olivia J. Brown, on training. They start their day with a stretch while camera and lighting are setting up. She'll have Peyton punching stunt pads, throwing kicks, and drilling takedowns, all before heading in to coordinate a fight scene.
But I love now that I have like 5 different ways that I can take someone down.
Billy Zabka admires Mary Mouser so much because she's the one in the cast who's practicing and doing katas between takes. Number 2. The trick to karate is to be one step ahead of your foe, we think. The pandemic may have forced everyone to mask up, but that hasn't slowed down the Cobra Kai crew even the slightest.
It's a whole different way of making a TV and film.
They're about to wrap up season 5 already. It must be mind-bending trying to keep track of where the audience is at when you talk spoilers versus where they're at while they're filming. They're a whole world ahead of us. Number 3. Terry Silver is striving for gold this time around. Thomas Ian Griffith has joined the cast for the 4th season, returning after many years as Terry Silver. It's definitely a nerve-wracking thing to return to a character you played years ago. You grow, you change, you become a different person. He was wondering what it would be like walking on set and becoming Terry Silver again, if he would be fighting it or embracing it.
I wasn't sure going in if this would be right creatively.
But once he heard how they were fleshing out a two-dimensional archetypal character and making him a character with gray areas and inner demons, it just felt like such a wonderful world to step into. Griffith is very passionate about his character, truly understanding that the way to play a good villain is not to see yourself as a villain in the role. What you're doing is justified in the mind of your character. That's what he calls the gray area. What Griffith says makes his character so interesting to him is he's created such a structure and lived a full life within it. When does that collapse and he become the person he's been fighting against his whole life? Number 4. If you trust your Miyagi instinct, you'll have a hit on your hands. After YouTube Red stopped producing scripted original programming, it left Cobra Kai without a home for its 4th season. But Netflix was happy to pick up the beloved show, which blew up the fanbase for Cobra Kai. Billy Zabka had to remind himself to stay in the micro and not get wrapped up in all the new fans watching. Now the show has shifted its focus to the 3rd Karate Kid movie. While it is the weakest in the series, it's still beloved by many. And the writers saw it as an opportunity to do right by the characters and dive into their development. The one thing the creators always have in mind while they're making the show is, what would Mr. Miyagi do? How can they honor that legacy? With such a compelling reason to keep the show going, they are righting some wrongs and showing people there's still lots to love about the 3rd installment. Number 5. As it turns out, friendship can span generations. It's no secret that Billy Zabka, Martin Cove, and the OG Cobra Kais have been friends for years.
We've built a long relationship of trust, and it's instinctive.
It looks like this new generation of actors is exactly the same.
Jacob and Sholo and Joe live together.
After filming wraps for the day, often Peyton List will join them for dinner and watch a movie, which she really loves, since they're all away from their families. And look how excited Mary Mouser is to plug Tanner's audiobook.
Have you heard? Tanner Buchanan did an audiobook and it's on Audible.
He voiced The Great Gatsby, and she went so far as to obsess over his voice.
And he has the best voice ever and you should so listen to it.
What a friend.
That's actually just precious. And speaking of fans, did you hear about how much Andrew Garfield loves the show?
Cobra Kai became an obsession.
And how the cast sent him a thank you video? Now we want to see Garfield in the show. Well, we'll have to wait until season 6 at the earliest to see him. Will you be binging Cobra Kai season 4? What do you think the outcome of the All-Valley tournament will be? We know who we'll be rooting for. Hash Brown Team Cobra Kai. Thanks for watching.